is a popular favorite amongst all fans, but never won an Indy 500. And, of course, you know, his name is none other than Tony Kanaan, and this is his Geico Chevy for KV Racing Technologies. Now, what do you think of, what do you think of this car?
That's one of my favorite cars he's ever driven. I like the one that he's running now, the blue, green, and white, but still, that one's pretty neat.
The only thing that sucks is that he ran the speed scheme once at St. Petersburg.
I think he ran it maybe twice. Okay, well, I think he switched over to
I prefer the Tony Kanaan car because it is really an awesome car, and he does deserve an Indy 500 win.
Well, when I was at the 500 this year, every time I went by when he was leading, the crowd just kept getting louder and louder.
Well, because Tony Kanaan is a favorite amongst fans. Tony Kanaan is a really popular driver, you know what I mean?
I think Indy might have him,
though.
It's just pretty popular.
Well, he's just popular because he plays damn well, and so that's why everybody likes him.
True.
And he's the GoDaddy dude.
So he's really nice.
Yep, really nice amongst the fan base, and he's really nice amongst all the sponsors, the drivers. He's a really well-respected driver, I think.
He's the perfect person to replace Dan Weldon.
He's like Dan Weldon II, I think. That's what he is.
He's Dan Weldon.
He's like Dan Weldon.
Well, there's only one Dan Weldon.
Yeah, really. He was Dan Weldon. Okay, speaking of James Sims Cook, we were just talking about him. Here's his car. It's his GoDaddy Chevy for Andretti Autosport. Personally, this is my favorite Indy car. Like, this is actually my favorite. I don't know about you, Jack, as he is.
Gathering Lights is my favorite from the series, probably, but now the only disappointing part about this is, once again, he only ran it up till the Indy 500, I'm pretty sure, because they changed just a little bit of the sponsor deal, but it was quite a cool car. The GoDaddy car is really cool,
Yes, they're kind of breaking up there, but yeah, overall you're just saying like this is a really cool paint team despite the fact that this was changed at the Indy 500.
Pretty much, yeah.
Yeah, but overall this is a really cool paint team, and I really do love the new Dallara chassis on this car, especially with the tire guards and the new side plates on them, which look really awesome.
I think I do, but I don't really know. Well, Oh, made changes to two pit crews, okay. So let's check our preview here. Okay, I guess we're gonna blast some tunes real quick. We got about 15 minutes, guys. 15 minutes till we go live, so I'm gonna give you guys another 15 minutes. I just wanna get more people in here. So we'll go with my 10 in a row playlist.
I'm not afraid. It's been a ride. I guess I had to go to that place to get to this one. Now some of you might still be in that place, trying to get out. So I'm taking Fox going hard with the R&B Saints. Turn it up! 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 You gon' take a swing off these turns before I sink. Just stay away, I won't let you stop me from crossing, man. What I'm saying, what you stop from my duty. I don't give a damn what you think. Doing this for me, so fuck the world, feed it me. Just gas it up, but swoop down on me and tear it down the balconies. No effect, that's some time to ask you why I have to lose. From infinite down to the last relax album. They just sit and rap with these on salary. Play hourly, it's very bad salary. Shit just bounce out of them. Whichever comes first, for better or worse. He's married to the kid, like a fucking for Christmas. He's giving us a curse, but give me earth. He's got the urge to pull his dick from the dirt and fuck the whole universe. Instead of getting crown your king cap into the fans, I'll never let you down again, I'm back. I promise to never go back on that promise. In fact, let's be honest, at last relax. See, it was there, perhaps I ran them back some things at the ground. Relax, I ain't going back to that now. All I'm trying to say is get back your black crown. Cause I ain't playing around. It's a game called circling, I don't know how. I'm way too worried to back down. But I think I'm still trying to figure this crap out. Thought I had it mapped out, but I guess I didn't. This fucking black crown. So I could come back a brand new me, you have seen me through. And don't even realize what you did, believe me, you. I've been through the ringer, taking from little to the middle finger. I think I got a tear in my eye, feel like a king of my world. Haters can make like bees with their stingers and rock it. No more beef fingers, no more trouble from now on. I promise to focus solely on handling my responsibilities as a father. So I stop and I swear I always treat this group like my daughters and raise it. You wouldn't let the single single look, cause the way I feel, I'm strong enough to go to the club while I'm pulling a pump and lift the whole liquor cap out up, cause I'm raising the bar. I shoot for the moon, but I'm too busy gazing at stars. I feel amazing and I'm not afraid. I'm not afraid to take a step. You take a step. Everybody, everybody, come take my walk. It's going together through the storm. Whatever weather, on the wall. Let me know that you're not alone.
Just sinking in the ocean, but
again. It don't matter what you say, I know I could never face someone that could sound like you.
That we have left, we want to talk right down to earth in a language that everybody here can easily understand. We'll be right back.
Alright, guys. Here we go. We're getting ready.
This is DJ Devin Becker, your NASCAR rants, raves, craves, and everything in between. Like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter, use that hashtag NASCAR questions, add me on Skype, RockD150, you can be on the show this week, every week, any week, whatever it is up to you guys, use that hashtag NASCAR question to ask your NASCAR questions, they might just get answered on the show, and sit back, relax, turn those speakers up, pull those belts tight, we're going live.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, DJ Devin Becker right here, and what an amazing week we have ahead of us. It is Bristol. Bristol, 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 Bristol. Here we go again. It's Bristol. I mean, come on. It's the easiest pick of the year. It's Bristol. Who else to pick than Kyle Busch at Bristol? I mean, honestly, it is Kyle Busch at Bristol, probably one of the best drivers at Bristol. Kyle Busch, I honestly think Kyle is going to take that championship, not the championship, but the win at Bristol. It's just looking to be a good weekend for Kyle. He's had the bad luck this week. He's had the bad luck the last 2 months. And it's all going to be turned around. I'm going with Kyle Busch. You know, it's going to be Rowdy going to Victory Lane. He's always run good at Bristol. And unless his car is complete junk, there's no way he's gonna win at Bristol. Unless his car is complete junk or he gets wrecked, he's winning at Bristol. We all know it. And so, pretty much, Kyle's going to Victory Lane at Bristol. So, with that being stated right out of the gate, yes, that was a Raytona 500, Rowdy Busch, a great song, look them up, that song is available on iTunes, and you can find it on YouTube. I have it downloaded, so I don't need to. So, what to expect from Bristol? Probably going to expect a few drivers to clinch a chase spot at Bristol, you know. Mostless people that you think are going to clinch probably won't. I mean, there are 10 drivers that mathematically have a chance right now at clinching a spot. Seven can secure a top 10 spot.
Saturday at Bristol, regardless of any other driver does. Points leader Greg Biffle will clinch as long as he finishes 28th. 29th with the last one lap led, the 30th most laps led, and scenario for Matt Kenseth is 8th with no laps led, 9th with at least one laps led, 10th with most laps led. Junior lands a spot in the postseason with finishes of 6th with no laps led, 7th with at least one lap led, 8th with most laps led. 5-time Jimmy Johnson will punch his chase ticket with a victory or second place finish while leading the most laps. That's all he's got to do to clinch in. Keselowski, Truex, and Bowyer can reserve a spot in the chase, but are not yet in charge of their own destinies. The magic of the number is 97. Any driver 97 points ahead of 11th place leaving Bristol will officially clinch a top 10 spot. Those who can clinch at least a wild card, Keselowski, Stewart, Hamlin, Case King, Clint Bowyer, win, and Keselowski and Stewart are in. Hamlin, Kane, and Bowyer have to win on Saturday night to get some help. So those are the drivers who could possibly clinch a spot here for Bristol. And also, if you guys have not heard, Kyle Busch, the 18 JGR team penalized for rule infractions. NASCAR announced penalties and fines to the number 18 team that competes in the NASCAR Sprint Cup Series as a rule of infractions at Michigan International Speedway. The number 18 Toyota is found to be in violation of sections 12-1, actions determined to stock car racing, 12-4J, any determination by NASCAR officials that have the race equipment used in the event does not conform to NASCAR rules, and 20-2.3A, improperly attached weight of the 2012 NASCAR rulebook. The infraction occurred during a practice on August 18th. As a result of the violation, crew chief Dave Rogers has been fined $25,000 and placed on NASCAR probation until October 3rd. In addition, car chief Wesley Sherrill will be placed on NASCAR probation until October 3rd. NASCAR Integrated Market Communications, 8/21/2012. Everything's coming up about this Mark Martin's crash at Michigan. Michigan will talk to NASCAR about Martin's pit road wreck. This is a quick update real quick. Mark Martin walked away from his crash at Michigan International Speedway. But the side of his car was essentially impaled up by the end of the wall, raising questions about whether that spot, a gap in the barrier on pit road that leaves the edge of a wall exposed, creates a safety risk. A Michigan International Speedway leader later released a statement: "The safety of a driver is paramount," a spokeswoman said, "so we will seek NASCAR's opinion and work with them on any recommendations they may have on how we can improve any part of the competition area. That includes pit road, pit wall, the track, anything competition related. NASCAR is ready to take a look at Mark Martin's scary crash from over the weekend." Robin Pemberton, NASCAR's vice president of competition, says Martin's team will be consulted and aerial photos will be studied. Pemberton said Sunday's incident is a reminder that the work and safety says Sunday's incident is a reminder that the work on safety doesn't stop. Of course, the work on safety pretty much started ever since NASCAR started. All of auto sports has had NASCAR and everything. So, as I'm just going over this right here, here we go. This one's going to be a great one. Guess who's on the poll for the new NASCAR game? NASCAR the Game, Inside Line. The face of NASCAR's new game also happens to be the face of NASCAR. But that might not be a primary reason that Dale Earnhardt Jr. is a natural choice for the cover star of NASCAR the Game, Inside Line. Even though I drive cars for a living, it's fun to do it with the reset button, Earnhardt said. Earnhardt told USA Today Sports about his avid interest in video gaming. "It's definitely not foreign to me, and you can see me just as easily picking up a controller and playing it. It's comfortable and something I'll be able to speak intelligently about if I was in a room full of gamers. I think it's a good fit. Earnhardt was chosen for the game's primary ambassador via an online poll that drew more than 750,000 voters through heavily promotions in social media. He will be the focus of a marketing campaign launching next month before the game's November release. So, 2012, November 2012, in NASCAR The Game in Sideline comes out. Oh, and the big thing that everyone wants to talk about right now is the whole Jeff Gordon, Dale Earnhardt Jr. update. The Pure Michigan 400 has some shocking moments Sunday, including a verbal feud between Hendrick Motorsports teammates Jeff Gordon and Dale Earnhardt Jr. "Tell the effing 88 he can thank me later for not wrecking him," Gordon said through the race radio. Through the race with a pass, Gordon felt was a little risky to the front. Team owner Rick Hendrick sided with Earnhardt. "Man, you didn't do anything, just drive that thing to the front," Earnhardt finished fourth. Gordon finished a disappointing 28th after an engine failure, but later talked about the incident in the garage. "He took me four wide, then slid up in front of me in turn two," Gordon said of Earnhardt's pass. "I had to check up, and it could have wrecked all of us. It wasn't a smart thing to do, especially to a teammate, but he chose to do it, and it all worked out. I don't care who does it. I'm going to show my displeasure if they do something like that." So pretty much, you know, it's going to happen to everybody. Even if it's a teammate, like, somebody is going to go four wide. It's racing. If somebody goes four wide, somebody's going four wide. There's, like, no spot. There's no way you're going to be able to fix that. Somebody's going four wide. You're going four wide with them. If you're three wide already, don't be three wide if you don't want to go four wide. If you got a car that's faster than all three of you combined that's coming toward you, move out of the way or just back off and let him have that spot. Don't try to block him and move and make him go four wide. Move out of his way. Back off. Let him get around you. Get around the other two. Then go back around those two. Follow that driver. Don't try and block them. That was just stupid enough. And then for him to say that Junior drove up in front of him, he's about to turn. It's either he's going to stay on the bottom, which he was going to anyway. He was in front of you. It's more like when you all turned, you all came down behind him, not him sliding up in front of you. So, again, I don't really get that. But it's Jeff Gordon, me and Jeff Gordon. So, I want to hear your guys' opinions on this. So, use that hashtag NASCARQuestions. Add me on Skype. You guys can actually call in. You guys may be featured on the show. To rant on about this, as of course no one has added me on Skype yet. So, let's just continue on here. Bondo scheme. Where was it? I knew I had one on here. And Keselowski saying everything. Okay, I know I'm going to find it here in a minute. I don't remember if it's up here or where it is. Is it up here? I could have sworn it was up here. Alright, well, I will find it, and I got some news for you guys. Oh, right there. So, right here, there's a little story on the jski.com. Cup news, Tom Menard and the whole 2017 penalized. NASCAR could come down on the number 27 Rich Childress Racing team after discovering irregularities with the frame rails on the car driven by Paul Menard last weekend at Michigan. Menard's car was taken to the Research and Development Center in Concord, North Carolina after finishing ninth in the Pure Michigan 400. Sorry about that, guys. I do not know who was just calling me. But let's get back to this. The Pure Michigan 400. NASCAR has issued penalties, suspensions, and fines to the number 27 team of NASCAR in the NASCAR Sprint Cup Series as a result of rule infractions discovered this weekend during post-race inspection at the NASCAR Research and Development Center following last Sunday's race at Michigan International Speedway. The number 27 team was found to be in violation of sections 12-1, actions to stock car racing, 12-4K race equipment that has been previously certified or previously approved by NASCAR for use in an event. Pursuant to subsection 8-12, has been altered, modified, repaired, or changed in any manner, intentionally modifying frame rails for the purpose of deceiving NASCAR's inspection gauges of the 2012 NASCAR rulebook. As a result, crew chief Slugger Labby has been fined $100,000, suspended from NASCAR until October 3rd, and placed on probation until December 31st. Car chief Craig Mockstad has been suspended from NASCAR until October 3rd, and what the heck? Okay, I don't even know what just happened. Okay, I think it just, like, freaking refreshed on me, but, I'll find it. Alright, we found it. So, has been suspended until October 3rd, and placed on probation until December 30th, while crew member Grant Hutchinson has also been suspended from NASCAR until October 3rd and placed on probation until December 31st. Driver Paul Menard and owner Rick Childress have been penalized with the loss of 25 championship driver and owner points, respectively. So, again, you guys can call in on Twitter, on Skype, call me on Twitter, add me on Twitter. Do whatever you need to do. This is there on the Twitter, and on my Skype, add me on Skype, RockerD150. You guys can call into the show and rant on about anything you guys want. Go right ahead. Okay, so now let's find something interesting. A little later on, again, I want your guys' input on anything NASCAR-related. Call me up on Skype. Add me on Skype. You guys can be on the show. As I said at the beginning, add me on Skype. Find me on Skype. Do whatever you need to do to get on my Skype. And you guys can be on the show this week, next week, any week, any week. Every week and any week, you guys feel like it. Joe Gibbs was supposed to have Trans Lux on the Sprint Cup car of number 11 Denny Hamlin later this year, but the company allegedly hasn't paid for its sponsorship of JGR. According to the lawsuit filed earlier this month, Translux, which manufactures video display boards, including scoreboards for everything from high school fields to arenas, sponsors of Joey Logano in his Nationwide Series car, California, earlier this year. According to the news release at the time, the sponsorship would move to Hamlin's Cup car for one race this fall, 2012, and also it included access to NFL Hall of Fame coach and team owner Joe Gibbs. The two-page lawsuit filed by JGR on August 3rd in North Carolina Superior Court in Charlotte does not list the amount of sponsorship deal, which was signed in 2011. It alleged that Translux breached the contract by failing to make various payments when due. So here we go. We already got lawsuits going on between Joe Gibbs. And, of course, that's always going to be up in the air. Of course, Joey Logano's future with Joe Gibbs Racing. Joey Logano, 22, has been with Joe Gibbs Racing since he was 16. The organization has a lot of invested in him. Logano has a lot invested in the organization. There are loyalty issues on both sides. But without a guarantee of sponsorship to drive fall season in 2013 and beyond, with primary sponsor Home Depot likely going to Matt Kenseth next year, of course, the opportunity to latch with the Shell Pennzoil and another sponsorship at Penske would be too good to pass up. Here's what we know. Logano has two offers on the table, including one from Gibbs. The JGR offer depends on sponsorship, and team owner Joe Gibbs said on ESPN on Wednesday that everything is up in the air with Logano. Without directly addressing Kenseth, Gibbs said he hoped to be able to announce something in 2 weeks with coincidentally would have the Cup Series in Atlanta, the headquarters for Home Depot. Logano said last week he should have clarity in a few days and 2 weeks with the 2 weeks now in the equation since a few days has passed. He also was non-committal on whether he preferred to stay at Joe Gibbs Racing. Everybody knows what's going to happen next year. Kyle's leaving. Now, actually, let me just give you this real quick. I can find this. I will actually have this up here in a minute. I believe I can get this done. If I can get it correctly. I can actually tell you everybody whose contract is ending right now. So, here we go. Contracts that expire this year. So, Penske Racing will switch to Ford. Miller Lite Keselowski, 2015 is an option year. The Wolf and Wolf extended to 2015, maybe. McMurray supposedly signed a multi-year extension in May to stay at Earnhardt Ganassi Racing. Belkin will be the sponsor at Martinsville in April. Banana Boat scheduled to the sponsor of Pocono. Liftmaster scheduled for New Hampshire in September. McDonald's and Bass Pro Shop return in 2012 as primary sponsors, each about 15 races or so. So, where is it? I know that I found it. I have it in here somewhere. Okay, Timmy Hill, probably gonna end up getting the, Rookie of the Year. It could either be him, it could be either be Timmy Hill, Josh Wise, or Stephen Lynch. I get a feeling it will actually come down to either Timmy Hill or Josh Wise. It'll probably be Josh Wise because he's running more races than, Hill and Lynch. So, Eric Almirola released and suspended for violating substance abuse. Idiot. Eric Almirola, 1 year deal in the 43. Kurt Busch, 1 year deal in the 51. Matt Kenseth leaving Roush. Joey Logano contract ends. Ryan Newman contract ends. David Reagan contract ends. David Rudiman, 1 year deal with Tommy Baldwin Racing. Reagan Smith contract ends. Martin Truex Jr. contract ends. Brian Vickers part-time in the 55, eight races. Those are potential free agents for 2013. When Kenseth makes that deal and signs that little piece of paper stating that he's going to Gibbs, we all know Trevor Bayne will be sitting in that seat on taking over the 17 ride. It's a given already. So, unofficial full-time rides by manufacturing car assignments. 40 full-time teams. Chevy 16. The 1, 5, 10, 14, 24. Yeah, we don't need to that. 11 teams. Wow. Some part-time teams. Unassigned numbers for 2012, 00, 01, 02, 03, 04, 05, 06, 07, 08, 0, 3, 4, 8, you can't use 3, I'm sorry. Numbers are owned and assigned by NASCAR. NASCAR teams request a number and hold for license, so, okay. I could have sworn I had it. Kyle Busch's contract ends this year. I know. But where does it state that? Because I already know that his contract ends. All of Gibbs' drivers' contract ends. So, who hasn't driven that 33 car this year? Let's see, who has? Stephen Lynch. Austin Dillon, Hermie Sadler, what? Brendan Gaughan and Elliot Sadler. Okay then. Okay, Dave Blaney, the 36, was the 35. David Gilliland, Ryan Newman, his contract ends. Juan Pablo Montoya, Eric Amarola. So, who do you guys think is going to go and actually end up joining? Who's going to Penske next year? I want to hear your guys' calls, so add me on that Skype, get your calls in, use that hashtag NASCAR questions as I refresh my Twitter, and you guys can be featured on the show.
No. I think someone's here. I think I'm right.
Ah, that's warm. This one's a cold one. Oops. Put that there. So, yeah, quick add me on Skype. It is RockerDude150. And as long as you guys got a mic on your computer, add me. All you gotta do is call me. You guys can be on the show. You guys can rant, rave, everything. So, now that we're just sitting here waiting, let's go into our Oxford Plain Speedway news real quick here. Little Oxford update. No, we're not. So, if you guys live in the Maine area, we have a driver appreciation, Time Warner Cable driver appreciation night at Oxford Plain Speedway. It will feature Oxford Championship Series, the Outlaws, the Late Models, the Mini Stocks, and the Strictly Stocks. Wicked Good Racers with a halftime autograph session, which is awesome. There will also be a helmet pass to benefit Kyle Hewins now at Wednesday's race. All the cars and drivers will come out to the front stretch and collect for him. Thanks in advance for your support. Kyle Hewins. If you guys not hear this, he was racing the Rebel Division up at Oxford last Saturday night, and he says he smelled gas, and that's never a good thing at his feet. He spun out, he hit the front stretch wall, and his car burst into flames. He did not have the right gear on. He has third-degree burns on his legs, or on his right leg and both of his hands. So, again, I want to know what you guys think. Add me on that Skype, call me up, you know, send your support out to Kyle. You know, he went through surgery, he was life-flighted to Burn Center here in Maine, and let's give you guys a quick little race results here from Saturday night. This was from Wednesday. Oh yeah, that was yesterday. So your Renegade feature, new driver in the Renegade division, Carl Conton, wins the Renegade feature in the number 7 machine. Deanna Bisby takes boyfriend Troy Jordan's machine, Chevy Camaro, out and runs it in the Allen's Coffee Flavor Brandy Ladies Division. Call the Wild RV Sport Trucks. Ryan Fair again wins that one. It was all Ryan Fair, I'm telling you. 7 out of 20. He led from lap 7 to lap 20. Jeff Herbert, man is he winning a lot this year. Wins the Rebel feature. And here we go. Outlaw number 1 goes to Todd Bisby. First time he's actually won a race this year. He led apparently laps 4 to 20. A DQ for Kevin Morse. Outlaw number 2 went to Kerry Robinson. Fred Clevett got second. Pat Malloy got third. Now, let's give you guys a quick little Oxford update on standings.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Do you have any problems?
There's only that big one, that one big piece out there.
Okay.
It's, like, really big. All right.
Thanks.
Yep. So let's start with our Oxford Acceleration Series here. Point standings updated, I hope. Just a second. We're going to go main panel. No. We're going to go control. So right here. Just a second. Let me just move this over. So you guys can see here, your Renegades points leader is Gerald Cote. Gerard Cote in the 05, Bill Grover, Jeff Lowe, William Dunphy Jr., and Harvey Post. I can't even pronounce that. Dang, they got freaking 14 Renegades. Wow. Ladies division, man, Tasha Dyer still leading, but only 30 points ahead of Dottie Betray. Missy Morgan's right there with 4-4-4. Rachel DuBois, rookie, the only rookie. She's going to win rookie in the year for them. And that 21 machine at 4-42. She's just 2 points out of third for a rookie. That's pretty good. And Sue Vinot's fifth. And I'm surprised Ryan's not on the top of the Colorado RV Sports Trucks, but then again, he did get that DQ. So right there, you got Gerald McKenna, Ryan Ferry, Corey Williams, Jeff Schmidt, and Neil McKenna. All of them right there. That is your top five in the Colorado RV Sports Trucks. Mike Ward leads Brady Romano by 2 points. 2 points, guys. 2 points. Nate Dubeck is tied with Brady. So tied for second. Just 2 points out of the lead, though. That's pretty good. Come on, Brady. You can do it, buddy. And then you got Mike Carver and Dustin Sally. And then here we go. This one's going to be great. Matt Dufault's leading your Oxford Outlaw division. Mike Haynes is second. Only a good 12 points out of the lead. Josh Childs is third. Dan Brown fourth. And Mike Blue's fifth. And as you guys can see, there's a lot. So, Rookie of the Year standings. Harvey's leading it. And then you got Rachel, who's obviously going to win. Neil McKenna. Joel's sucking right now. Sorry about that, Joel. If you're listening, sorry, Joel. Cody Chasson's going to lead the Rookie of the Year. I got a feeling he's going to win. He's 80 points ahead of Eddie Smith. And Treadwell beats Hewins. Sorry, Kyle, but he's going to beat you either way. Toothaker's coming up there. Timmy Young, I don't like him. Jeff Jordan, not doing so well this year. So that's a little Oxford update. So remember, use that hashtag NASCAR questions on Skype. Actually, add me on Skype, RockerDude150. I cannot stress it enough. So add me on Skype. You guys can be on the show, which is a privilege in itself. Podcast preview. Just checking out my preview here. And we've been going for a good strong few minutes here. And again, remember, you guys can use the hashtag NASCAR question and ask your questions on Twitter, and I will try and answer them the best that I can. So, Michigan. Biffle wins. Pretty much all we care about. Biffle wins. He's probably going to clinch it. He's probably going to clinch Chase spot at Bristol. Few weeks, I will be in New Hampshire for the Loud race in September. I'm bringing back nothing. But pretty much, you know, it's going to be Biffle clinching at Bristol. Winning at Bristol is going to be Kyle Busch. We already know this. That's pretty much why I played the Kyle Busch song before the show even started. So, pretty much, that's, you know, Biffle clinches, we already know that, unless he gets wrecked. That's the only way he's not going to clinch. Pretty much. So, Mark Martin's okay. That's good. Good to see him okay. So, you know, I got nothing else to talk about this week. Holy shiz. So, use the hashtag NASCAR questions on Twitter. Add me on Skype, RockerD150. This has been DJ Becker. I'm signing out right now. Sorry, guys. There's just nothing else to talk about. I'm out of here. Peace.
This is DJ Devin Becker, your NASCAR rants, raves, craves, and everything in between. Like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter, use that hashtag NASCAR questions, add me on Skype, RockerD150. You can be on the show this week, every week, any week, whatever it is. It is up to you guys. Use that hashtag NASCAR questions to ask your NASCAR questions. They might just get answered on the show. And sit back, relax, turn those speakers up, pull those belts tight. We're going live.